What's going on, community? This week we're going to do the compliment sandwich. So we're going to go positive, sandwich the negative, go back to positive, right? Okay, so the first, we'll start on the positive. So we've seen some more filing in RH's case. It's been the right kinds of things we want to see around this time, both in the way that they are challenging jurisdiction, which is a big one. So I know jurisdiction doesn't sound like a sexy topic by any stretch, but what it means is if they win jurisdiction, that means there's no case with the SEC. So when you hear this claim for jurisdiction, essentially it's essentially a motion to dismiss. And they can actually get certain pieces of this dismissed versus others. So again, it'll make a big impact. We still probably won't hear anything super significant for another month, give or take, with some resolution in June. And then again, no matter how positive these things go, we're most likely not to hear sort of the beginning of this stuff really start to really pick up some steam as far as the case until October. But we're seeing that stuff coming through. And then there's a big push out for amicus briefs. This is what several of these tweets that you see RH referring to and all these on the legal matter here. You're seeing some other people bring this up. And again, encourage teams to go reach out to lawmakers, to lawyers, to other teams, to DebtBox or these multiple other institutions and different companies who are filing for amicus briefs or going after the SEC. All these things are really important. So it's good to see that stuff moving through and progressing, right? That's what we all want. Now the middle, goodness gracious, these charts are rough. Again, depending on when time you go and look at the charts, we saw the kind of SAC level sort of be defended slightly there. There were some of those, funds associated with the African priest that had moved through and punched in a little bit. I think half a mil when I looked quickly, but we've seen it, depressed below there. So again, this is a juicy opportunity for anyone who's redeemed or who, was able to sell the top or looking to re-up DCA, taking a good position and then maybe move into something to LL, take full advantage of the big dip. Now is the time. That's the glass half full, right? Obviously, there's a big whirlwind over some misinformation and a few different things and some tweets. I didn't get a chance to respond. That's going to get come why will be apparent shortly. But CC did a fantastic video that even if you weren't concerned about the Katie's tweet or any of this other kind of stuff that's sort of been lurking, it's very informational. It's probably worth watching regardless. I was really glad that CC just took full time. It's fairly long. I think it's 20 plus minutes, but it goes in great depth. It's very, very positive. Great to see. So again, I think it's really informational. Now back to the top of the most positive part, why I didn't respond to the tweet or some of these other things. I am down. I'm actually getting married this week. So I've been doing a little traveling, getting together with family. Just so everyone knows, I've been kind of slow to answer a few things. I'm going to basically cut communications here in the next day or two. I'm going to, fully be in the moment, enjoy the opportunity and the time with the family. I got a few extra days down here, so it'll be a bit before I jump back on. Now I know, again, a lot of people that know, I'm almost always referring to Habibi as my wife. We actually did our religious ceremony and all those things. So this is the big ceremony for everyone to come together, her family, my family, friends, a lot of people to, finally kind of all get together under one roof. So we're really, really excited for that. So again, I've been traveling and that's the reason I haven't been quite as proactive as you typically see. And I'll be back very, very soon. So I'd appreciate all the congratulations. You guys, you can sell it on the charts a little bit if you guys want it. There's a pretty juicy dip there, but sell or buy, handle it how you want. Definitely check out CC's video. Make sure you're taking advantage of all these big opportunities. You never know when it's your last dip to catch here before we really take off. Getting close to that 52 weeks. We're getting closer to halving. All this big, big bull tilt, stand on the gas pedal, bull market signs are there. So guys, I appreciate y'all. Y'all be safe. Stop yelling at each other on Twitter. Happy Easter, all that good stuff. And I will not catch y'all next week.